Speed ramping. So today we're talking about speed ramps, and you may already know what a speed ramp is, you may not, you may know how to do some, you might not even know how to do them, but you might know what they are. There's a lot of you who may be interested in speed ramps, and this video is for you guys. What is a speed ramp? So basically what a speed ramp is, a way for you to speed up or slow down your clips gradually over the course of a certain amount of time that you can pick and choose from to change it from one speed to the next. So that's kind of confusing. Let me dumb it down for you. So let me draw a graph for you guys so you kind of understand a lot easier. So this is what a graph would look like if you were not using any speed ramps. This is what your clips would look like, the speed ratio, whatever you want to call it. This is what it would look like. Now, if you were to add a speed ramp, this is kind of what it would look like. It'd look a lot better. Now, if you even improved and eased your ramp, this is what your speed ramp would look like. Yeah. Pretty simple, I guess. That's kind of just what it looks like though. If you kind of put your mind to it, you may understand a little bit better. If you don't, then keep watching because I'm gonna be explaining that to you. So what a speed ramp is gonna do for you is have you give you that gradual point, that gradual decay, that gradual incline of speed, and you can use that to your advantage in so many creative ways. Now, a lot of people use it to show important moments in a clip. They use it to transition from one shot to the next. They use it to transition later into the shot. They use it even to just use it. Now, that's not the best time to use it, but that is something that people do. There are so many different ways you can use a speed ramp. Speed ramps are kind of for everyone. You can use it in anything you can do it in. You can use it in travel videos. You can use it in cooking videos. You can use it in tech videos. You can use it in product reviews. You can use it in makeup. You can use it in so many different contexts because it is such a versatile technique in film. It's a really good thing to know how to do. Personally, I do not use speed ramps all that often, but it is a great thing to know how to do just in case I want to do it, just in case someone asks for it, I'll know how to do it. Now, I have seen so many amazing uses of speed ramps, from revealing someone's face for, you know, increasing intensity of a shot. So there are so many like festival ones, but there was one that actually really, really piqued my interest. And here it is right here. Now, this was done by a guy named Jake Bain. And he is Crank Dad's photographer, and I love the way he did this video because this video is truly insane. It really shows the intensity. It really uses speed ramping to the advantage to increase the message, the feel, the vibe, the emotion in the video, and it hits those points and uses the musicality so well. Everything is hit perfectly. This is like a perfect example of how speed ramping can increase the intensity of your video. Now imagine what it would be like if it was just regular cuts, no speed ramp, and everything was just kind of just the same speed. Now, just imagine that. It'd have a completely different feel. Speed ramping can be used in so many different ways. Now, let's just stop talking about all the ways they can use it, from the transitions to the reveals and to the products and whatnot. Actually, let me give you one more example. So we're gonna be using this lens here, right? What lens is this? Who knows? We're gonna get to that. First, we're gonna have the lens here, right? And we're gonna be doing like a live, real-time speed ramp. This isn't gonna be a speed ramp at all, but I'm just gonna show you with my hands. It's focused on the back, right? So I was like, okay, whatever. So it's gonna start speed ramping. We're in the slow-mo. Can't focus. So we're in the slow-mo, it's turning, and then whoosh, and boom, and then it keeps going slow-mo and rotating, right? That's one way to use a speed ramp for a reveal, product video, whatever. So now we're gonna finally get into how to do a speed ramp. Now, it's fairly easy. All you gotta do is pull up your clip. Now, just before we get started with that, this is for Premiere Pro users. I'm not completely sure how to do it in Final Cut or any other program. I don't use them, I only use Premiere. Now, I do this by right-clicking or double-clicking on the FX tab, the effects box, corner, whatever, on your clip, and go to Time Remapping and click on Speed. Now, this opens up a whole new menu. It adds the ability to keyframe your speed on your video. Now, what we do here is we add a keyframe where we want to start the speed ramp, where we want to start speeding up our clip. When you add a keyframe, it'll show two markers where you added your keyframe. Now, this is for you to expand the region that you want to ramp. Now, this is like the physical ramp. So when you move the keyframe out, you're gonna have the diagonal line for your ramp. You can decide how long you want it, how long you want the ramp to be, how long you want it to go on for. And then you add another keyframe on the end point where you want it to end, and then you also, you know, handle the ramp. Now you have three different speed options now here. In the, you have the beginning, the middle, and the end. So you can speed up or slow down the middle depending on what you want to do. Now that's all up to you really, and you can kind of control that and, you know, see what you like. But once you have your keyframes and everything in place, you have the markers. So I want you to click on the marker, and then it's gonna show up this little line right on your ramp. Grab one of those orbs, those balls, those points at the ends of it, and drag it towards the clip. Now this is gonna ease your ramp and make the transition so much smoother. It's gonna look so much nicer, and you know, it's just a lot better than having a straight ramp. It's curved and it'll ease in a lot better and feel and look a lot better. So that's kind of all there is to speed ramping. It's a simple task, it is extremely easy, and there's so many possibilities with it. It's not restricted to just travel, it's available to everybody. So I really hope that you guys can take this with you and kind of learn speedrun, because I know you guys see it all the time. If you watch my videos, I'm pretty sure you watch a lot of other people who use speed ramps. I really hope you guys can take this with you guys and enjoy the versatility of camera work, of film, of all these effects you can do. Just explore those effects, or the capabilities of your program, of your camera, and all of that. So this is just one of many effects that you guys can do. So thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you guys hit that like button if you enjoyed this video. Share this video if you enjoyed it, and smash that subscribe button if you aren't already subscribed, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Stay awesome, guys, and have an amazing night, day, morning, wherever you're watching from. Everything's alright, so bright, I'm alright, I stay by your side.